1954, down in Chicago by the South Shore, baby girl is born that Christmas morn. Ooh, here comes drama. Of those Christmas babies that arrive, she's one of the lucky in the first five, wins free diapers, whole year's supply. Ooh, got a happy mama. The hospital nurses were more than delighted to help with the names. They get all excited. Name her Mary Carol. How about Christine? There's always Judy or Josephine, you know. Use the letter J in honor of the baby Jesus. But the parents were having none of that, so they gently replied to avoid a spat. Thank you for those names. We're not Christmas people, so if it's all the same, we thought we'd go with something Jewish. Something Hebraic. We'll call her Esther Shandel. That's quite a handle for a brand new baby. A trend was starting in the 1950s. Names were getting Americanized. Downsized, de-ethnicized, a futile attempt to depolarize. And so the family decides to be translating, truncating, ultimately assimilating. So the beautiful and biblical name of Esther Shandel gets homogenized on down. They call her Sally. That would be me. Now, being born on Christmas really sucks. I got a lot to say. You can trust my litany will be very long. For years, I've tried to write this song. I'm a cranky old broad with no decorum. I'm stealing licks from a talking blues forum. It's my turn to have my say, because I'm a Jewish kid. Born on Christmas Day. I'm a Jewish kid, born on Christmas Day. I remember back when I turned five, no birthday party would ever jive. No little friends could come around, cause the Jewish ones had all left town. They went to Florida, Christmas break at Bubby's house. And the Gentile ones? Well, come on, it's Christmas! Back then, gas stations and movie theaters were closed. It was nothing open. Goodness knows, just a rickety Chinese restaurant. Happy birthday, Sally. Have whatever you want. What do I know? I'm five. They give me rice and a fortune cookie. On our way back home from eating Chinese, we drive up and down the icy streets, peeking into windows, see Christmas trees. We'd have us a contest, which side of the street had the best Christmas lights, sparkly houses lit up bright. But I'm a little girl, I start to cry. I don't understand why the baby Jesus is out in the cold in the front yard manger, covered in snow. Why didn't they bring him in where it was nice and warm near the fireplace where the stockings were hung? Let him open presents with the girls and the boys. Give him Christmas cookies. Let him play with toys. I'd give him my fortune cookie. My fortune said, learn many languages. Go far. I wanted to learn to speak Catholic and go to Christmas. Cause I'm a Jewish kid, born on Christmas Day. I turned 10 in 1964. I was miserable down to my core. Radio and TV were a horrid bore. Remember, before cable? Radio blasting choirs from the Vatican, TV humming with off-the-air patterns, Christmas people rushing everywhere. For us, alienation and despair. There was nothing to do but sit and wait and wait. As the world came to a screeching halt, midday on December 24th, folks said, don't worry kids, it's over soon. Felt like we were lost, marooned. Thankful our cousins from Skokie would visit. Aunt Lil was planning on bringing a brisket. She called to say they were out of gas. Stations were closed, they'd have to pass. Oh, happy birthday, Sally. My mom starts to bake a cake. We're out of eggs. Oy. Well, really, I could go on and on. No doubt this is one depressing song. Truth is, no one forgets my birthday because they know it's a drag, and they all call to say, hey, what a drag. And I say, yeah, thanks, and then I ask them what they got for Hanukkah, because now, this year, it's also Hanukkah. I get birthday calls on Christmas Eve, so now I call it Birthday Eve. Just a chosen few get Birthday Eve. Who? I'll tell you. Humphrey Bogart, Jimmy Buffett, Annie Lennox and Sissy Spacek, I wonder if they'll get birthday presents wrapped in Christmas paper. Look, it's Charlie Brown with Lucy and Linus dressed as the three wise men standing over Snoopy as, shh, the baby Jesus. In spite of myself, I've grown up trying not to be a bitter adult, but the biggest mishigas of all is when I'm out shopping at the mall. I've had a lovely time perusing. My credit card is perched for using. The cashier asks for my ID. I hand it over. He takes a peek and then I hold my breath as I wait to see if he notices. Yep, he notices. Stand back. Here it comes every time. Oh, you're a Christmas baby. Right then and there, I have to make a choice to just say thanks or raise my voice and let loose with my talking blues. But hopefully I'm smart enough to choose to just let it go. Turn the other ear, because that's what the shh baby Jesus would do. He too was a Jewish kid, born on Christmas Day.